So today's workout will be a shoulder workout. I'm going to start with seated shoulder presses, dumbbell shoulder presses, and work my way up. So I'm going to start off here with 72 pounds, which is green on the 12 and a half handle, and do some shoulder presses, kind of get some blood moving. And do a couple sets of that and see how that feels. Do a heavy seated shoulder press and then move on to a next movement. So I'm going to start with that. Make sure to warm up a lot. So 72 and a half. Have to kick the weight up, keep the abs tight. A little heavy warm-up set. Go up from there. Gonna be drinking some tea and resting a minute or so between sets. On the shoulder press, seated shoulder press, I'm trying to get a firm base to kind of push from. The hoist machine that I have here for the bench, the adjustable bench, I can't get locked in as well as I'd like on a normal gym seated bench that is kind of bolted down. Also, some of the seated benches have leg, allow you to kind of put your legs up more at an angle so you can kind of push off of it to get the weight up. That's probably the easiest machine, and it's bolted down normally, or they're all bolted down. So the only issue with this is it's kind of hard to get a firm base. And then if you're doing it by yourself, getting the weight up to be able to press. It's a lot easier when it's really heavy with the spotter, or you just have to get that strength of being able to get the weight up, which just comes with practice, which I don't do these as much as I should. So I'm at 72 and a half pounds. I'm going to move up to the yellow on this, which is the 87 and a half pound for my second set. The bottle's getting it up. So right leg first. Getting the weight up is a very kind of power movement. Gotta be explosive. Now, I should be doing 95s because this weight's getting heavy for me, but I'm going to try 102.5, which I haven't done in a very long time. So if I can get the weight up, I think I can do it. And if I keep my stable base, that's kind of the key for this exercise. So I'm going to give myself 30 or so more seconds, maybe a little longer, and go for it. I did, when I was walking by, knock the bench like this, just kind of disconcerting. Adjustable benches are nice, but they're perfect for home use, because you're not going to buy, unless you have a really big gym setup, you're not going to buy a fixed set benches with different setups to do your different exercises or whatever. That's not really practical unless you have a full equipped gym. So if you're just kind of the layman home gym setup, the kind of the key pieces of equipment, normally what people say is adjustable bench and then a power rack and a barbell. That's like the basic necessity for most people. I kind of have a different take on it. I'm really a fan of dumbbell work. I think, one, my setup that I have here for my home gym is much easier to do than a normal barbell type power rack. If you've seen other YouTube videos of people with home gyms and they have their gym in the kitchen, which I essentially do, this is one big large living room. It looks really out of place and it takes up a lot of space. My setup, if I just have the power rack and the stand, and I have extra stuff, so it makes it look more cluttered. And there are other benches that are you can fold away or whatnot, or hide against the wall. You can basically minimize the space and not take up a huge amount of space. I think the stand is key. You really need a stand, especially for the heavy dumbbell sets. I'm not going to be picking the dumbbell up from the ground with 175 pounds and then doing something with it. It's a lot more effort. You can, if you're doing less weight, I think it's more practical. But for me, this is a setup I think is easiest, and I think most people should have. If you're starting out, you can get just the regular power blocks that go up to 70 or 90 pounds. And that'll be plenty of weight. And then as you get stronger, you can upgrade. The only thing that's kind of hard to do is leg type work, but if you have an adjustable set up a bench like I do, you can buy the attachments and do leg curls, leg extensions. You can do Bulgarian split squats. You can do all sorts of different movements. Anyway, I gotta do my set. I'm taking up too much time. So I'm gonna try the 100 pounds. Now I'm gonna do sitting shoulder raises on arm is 20 pounds. I'm going to superset this with dumbbell flies. One arm raises 20 pounds. First I do. Take a drink. Can I rest for a second? Thank you. I'm gonna do a set or more. I'm gonna give myself another little rest here. Basically, my general idea that I did was I tried to do a heavy set, which was too heavy for me. And I'm trying to get in some, finish the workout because I'm getting tired. So I'm like, okay, I'll superset. So, seated. One arm, shoulder raise, and then side lateral. Kind of get some blood moving. That's the thought process. My strength is not great right now. It's hard to do these. Do one more, and I'll figure out what I want to do. So what I'm trying to do here is I'm doing another shoulder movement. I'm kind of lifting up and feeling my whole shoulder kind of work as I lift it up. I normally do these with barbells, generally like the easy curl, flat bar in the curling area. I know for some people this movement hurts their shoulder. So if it does, don't do it. I've heard that this exercise is kind of hard on the shoulder, so kind of like a grinding type movement, hard on the rotator or whatnot. I don't know if that's true. So I'm gonna do 25, so I'm gonna do 27 and a half, or I'll do. Yeah, I'm just gonna slowly move up, slowly move up. So this is only a couple pounds more, like 2 pounds more. 2.5 pounds more. Feels really awkward with a dumbbell. Can move up to 35s. I'm also going to superset and a little bit of shrug work. So I kind of do a motion where the back part of I shrug that part up and down. So this is 35 pounds. I'm not liking that shoulder movement. I never really liked it. Feels a little uncomfortable. Do a little bit more shrugs. gonna be a short little 30-minute workout. That's it for today, a little shoulder workout and a little shrugs at the end.